In the film Manufacturing Consent, there's some old TV footage with you debating William F. Buckley Jr. on Firing Line, this television program. Buckley is apparently holding a button in his hand, and whenever his argument becomes weak, he presses the button and the network cuts to a commercial.
Yeah, I noticed that while I was on.
I bet. If there were no commercials and he didn't have the button to hide behind, would there be... Could he defend his right-wing opinions?
No, I'm not the one to pass judgment on that.
Well, okay.
I mean, I don't think so. I mean, yes, in a way.
But
I mean, I think you can defend almost anything,
right,
if you're slick enough.
Yeah.
And there's not enough time, and you know debaters' tricks and so on.
Right.
I mean, there's virtually nothing that you couldn't. That's. I mean, take say debating.
Right.
You know, which I think is one of the dumbest human activities that there is. But formal debating.
Okay.
Well, you know, in formal debating, good debating teams are trained to take both sides of an argument, right? That's what a formal debate is. You're supposed to be able to defend both sides of the argument. And I don't think it's very hard to do. You know, within that, within a controlled format, there's almost nothing you can't defend with the right sort of tricks and with the... you don't have to present that much evidence, and you know, you can say things that there's no way to challenge, and so on and so forth. So yeah, sure, you can probably defend anything in a brief span of time with enough limitations on how far you can go.
But let's say you created, or the community created, an accessible, level playing field debate style television program with enough time, like 2 or 3 hours, to go into the issues in depth.
Yeah.
Could that serve as a cornerstone, in effect, of a direct democracy?
Sure, I think that'd be terrific. And so anyway, I would question the debate style, however.
Well, okay, not debate.
There's something phony about the idea of debates.
Mm.
I mean, a debate is based on the principle that you don't change your mind. Like, if you and I were to have a debate,
that
would mean I stand up for X and you stand up for not X, and we're not allowed to change our minds. Like, in a debate, I'm not allowed to say, hey, that was a good point. I think maybe you're right. I'll change my mind about that. You're not allowed to do that in a debate. What you have to do is hold on to your position no matter what. And that's just irrational.
Right. So perhaps a talk show or
a
something.
Discussions make sense.
Larry King, in effect.
Well, discussions make sense.
Yeah.
And sure, the freer they are and the broader they are and the more views get expressed and the more...